Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you all for being here. Today, we have a very exciting announcement about a project to transform the Quicken Loans Arena. You can see on the monitors here that the images are up for the proposed transformation. Pretty exciting. Almost 2 years ago, the Cavs approached the county and the city to ask if we could help fund this $140 million transformation. The Cavaliers offered to pay half the cost, which I will tell you is very unusual given these types of projects, especially in a publicly owned facility. We knew that the deal was crucial to continuing the great momentum that the city and county are experiencing. And we recognize that the Q is the largest economic driver for our region. In 2016 alone, the Q generated $245 million in direct spending, which helps to retain and create jobs. $44 million in state, city, and county taxes were generated by events at the Q, with $20 million of those coming to the county and the city. So we began the long process of figuring out how to make the deal work and how the public sector might come up with $70 million. And with some creativity, we figured it out. And we figured it out without raising taxes. Most of the funds will come from revenue streams that already exist and are generated or directly impacted by the Q. Now, we recognize that our community has significant social service needs. We're not using any general fund or health or human service levy dollars for this project, and this will cause no cuts to county or city services. We cannot use the sin tax dollars because they're allocated to the upkeep and maintenance of facilities and not for capital improvements like the one we're talking about. We're using hotel and admission taxes already dedicated to bonds for Gateway and the Q. When those are paid off, some of these funds will be used for this project. Destination Cleveland is contributing hotel taxes, which are designated for travel and tourism infrastructure projects. By finishing the Hilton under budget and with our expected revenues, we can use part of the savings for this project. The Cavaliers are expected to generate more sales taxes at the Q as a result of this project. We will use those additional taxes. The Cavaliers expect to generate additional admission taxes due to the Cavaliers reaching the playoffs. We'll use those additional playoff taxes. We used the Cavaliers' projections for those additional sales and playoff admission taxes. But what if those projections are not met? Another very unique aspect of this deal is that if the additional sales taxes don't happen, or if the admissions taxes fall short, the Cavaliers pick up the shortfall through a rent adjustment. And the Cavaliers will cover any overruns or additional costs for the project. What does the public get in response, in exchange? We transform the Q into a more competitive world-class facility. The average lifespan of an arena is 20 years, 22 years. The Q is already 22 years old. The Cavaliers will extend their lease for 7 more years, which means we will lock down the Cavs here in Cleveland until 2034 without having to build a new arena, which might cost $600, $700, $800 million. You could look at the deal as costing $10 million a year for those extra 7 years. As I said, building a new arena would be exorbitant, at least $600 million. At that price, we'd be looking at a cost of something more, closer to $30 million per lease year, per additional year. And there's more. With this new project, the NBA has promised to bring an All-Star Week to Cleveland when this project is complete. The All-Star Week will put us once again on the international stage and could bring us as much as $100 million in economic benefits. In addition, the Cavaliers have agreed to donate at least 15,000 free tickets a year to the community for Q events, including 10,000 Cavs tickets and 5,000 for other events. So people who might not otherwise be able to enjoy Q events will be able to do so. The construction will also support new jobs, and the Cavs have signed on to the Gateway Inclusion Policy and the city and county inclusion policies, which support inclusion and diversity in employment practices. I'm so pleased with the true spirit of collaboration that it took to make this deal happen. We've had the support of the city, the county, and Destination Cleveland, and our business community. All were crucial to putting this program together. I'd like to particularly thank Tim Aftermat and Fred Nance, as well as Joe Roman, who are available to answer questions, especially if you have tough ones. I'll turn it over to them after we're done here. And now I'd like to introduce Mayor Frank Jackson, who's been extremely supportive and, I will say, absolutely critical to getting this deal done. I want to thank the mayor publicly for all your help and for your help financing the project.